Banner had relayed his concerns about changing any reality's history too much, fearing the possibility that it might somehow accidentally set him off course from the other stops along the way of his mission. Plus, if anything happened to him that prevented him from returning the rest of the stones, it would mean far greater destruction for entire realities, let alone one of the Nine Realms. As much as Steve hated the position he was in, the one thing that always centered him reinforced the choice he knew he had to make. The mission. Focus on the mission. Suddenly, a blood-curdling scream filled the air. Steve turned and ran from the balcony back into the room. His fighting instincts had kicked in, but they quickly cleared once he saw what was happening. There was Rocket, standing over the unconscious body of whom Steve had to assume was Jane Foster. Had Steve beaten him there? Perhaps Banner knew that Steve would only have so long to restore the ether to her body and had to make sure he'd have as much time as necessary. If that was the case, it would have been nice to have been informed about it. Steve ducked away behind one of the room's large stone pillars to avoid being seen by Rocket, whom he could hear muttering under his breath as his specially designed extractor went about its business gathering the ether from Foster's system.
Thunder gods, aliens, floating cities, no problem. But someone with fur says hello and she faints dead away. Freaking humans.
Unhand her, foul rabbit!
That was a voice Steve didn't recognize. It was quickly followed by many more who had presumably heard Foster scream.
No! No! You guys all got the wrong idea! She was like this when I got here!
Then why are you holding the ether she was infected with?
Oh, is that what this is? I was wondering why that dark elf asked me to hold it for him. I think I'll go give him a piece of my mind.
And you expect us to believe you?
As sure as I'm a rabbit.
Thor!
Steve heard Rocket run out of the room, followed by what sounded like 100 Asgardian soldiers. At least a couple stayed behind, as Steve could hear them place her unconscious body on the room's bed.
No one is to enter except Thor himself! For Odin! For Asgard!
The guards replied in unison.